Kiro Talk, and this is the Breaking News Wahala segment. And today on the Breaking News, we have loads of things for you, loads of news rather for you. First, we'll be talking about the Ghanaian couple, the Ghana couple that married an European man. I'll also move to the Canada Toronto ballroom that Chimerezi went to. We'll be giving us the spicy gist and what really happened, just a breakdown of it. I'll also be talking about what happened in the weekend, some of the things happened in the weekend, just a little bit of spice. So this Breaking News Wahala is a special one. So let's start with the video. So you guys check out this video of the Ghanaian man who married a white European man. Check out the video.
Mr. and Mrs. Schmidt.
Walking down there. Yeah.
Wow. Aww. Family Schmidt. Game is over. Woo!
Ja. So, ich bitte euch wieder ein kleines Fläschchen Sekt zu nehmen, ja? Mhm. Dann können wir noch mal anstoßen. Dann füllt die Farben an und dann fahrt ihr bitte alle mit uns. Ja, ich hoffe, dass das irgendwie passt. Ja, wir schauen mal. Wir haben...
Colin.
Bitte, Foto, Foto mit den Kindern.
Bitte
verteilen, aber ich muss bitte hin. Ich nehme die Bag ist besser als sie.
Joel.
So now that you guys have checked out that video and you've seen the marriage, the happy marriage, so we're starting with the, before people start calling us, there's only bad news that we break. At least now we're breaking the good news. So Chimerezi, would you like to go first? What do you feel about that? No, we'll just be talking about the marriage and also talking about LGBTI relationships, just in general. So first, what do you think about this marriage?
I feel this marriage is a very good thing because most people think that LGBTQ relationships are just games. You just feel, oh, I'm just dating. Or like most people say, ah, it's because you don't want to get a girl pregnant or because you don't want to use birth control. So you're just having fun around. And when I'm done having fun, then I'm just going to get married. It shows that LGBTQ relationship is not all fun, games and sex. It shows that they are people who are really legit in a relationship because they know at the end of the relationship, that relationship is going to lead to marriage, which is what we hope. It also shows that it also changes the perspective in the LGBTQ community that we are not all holes. Some of us want to have family, which is one thing that we are exaggerating for, or we are trying to incorporate into the community so that people will see that our community has diversity. If you want to be a whole, good for you. You want to get married, settle down with one partner, good for you. Want to be monogamous, good for you. Want to be polygamous. You also have varieties of choices, which is helping to change the culture in the LGBTQ community. Another thing that really interested me in that video is that if you look at the two couples that are getting married, they are genuinely getting married. And honestly, I cannot say
how sure.
From the clip, I can say to an extent they are genuinely getting married because
it looks like for me. Sorry to say, people might call me a bad belle, but you look like a grandfather getting married to maybe a stepson.
Irrespective of their age, I could see the happiness in their faces, the smile.
The black guy will be happy because he's going to get a visa now.
But that is where I disagree with you, Mr. Achafo. I feel that this marriage is a genuine marriage, it's a legal marriage, and they are marrying because they are in love. Though there may be some benefit when it comes to marriage. So there may be some benefit when it comes to marriage.
There may be some benefits.
Yes, marriage comes with benefits. That's why people say when you get married, door opens. Like, obviously, nobody just get married.
Getting
just
married for love. Okay, now it's for the green card.
No, there is love. Love is one part of marriage. But there are also some benefits. Financial stability, companionship, what else? And having family, you know. It's also all those other benefits. And networking is also one of the benefits from getting married. And even self-care, too, is one of the benefits from getting married. So there are all these benefits from getting married that we can't deny. But on my own part from the video, I honestly feel and I hope they are genuinely getting married. I love the gown of the groomsman. It was so amazing having the flower. It shows that you could still have an LGBTQ wedding and still have some style to read, but I feel like if that was my wedding, it would be a lot different. I would have chosen another style of apparel, because like for me, when it comes to my dream wedding, my dream wedding is going to be like a Wakanda style. Oh, we are not wearing no white and black. It is too cliche. It is too old. I'm going to add some African flowers texture. I'm going to add some African touch. Like, on my wedding, I would like it to be like a not really like a beach, but a jungle kind of African wedding where we could even have some form of, you know, domestic animals in display, just to spice up the whole wedding. Something different from the regular cliche of people just coming and seeing, you know, sitting down. It's gonna be like Tarzan. It's gonna be like a Tarzan theme wedding for me. So that's it for my wedding. And I love the fact that they just had a small wedding. But for me, I feel like a small wedding is good depending on the situation when you're getting married. But for me, I'd have loved to have at least 100 people at my wedding. At least. But more than 100 persons present at my wedding.
So for me, I would just say it again. It felt like a sugar daddy getting married to a twink. Not like it's a bad thing, though. But anybody that watched that marriage, if it's not a member, you know, it's one thing for us to come as member of LGBT community member and say, oh my God, be happy for them, this and that. But I'm just saying my own opinion. That's how it felt. It felt like this person was also an opportunity to leave a homophobic country like Ghana, and he took it. And it could be, it's probably, there's a 90% chance that it's genuine love, if not 100%. It's obviously love. It's obvious that two of them are LGBTI community members. They're both gay individuals who fell in love and got married. But I felt like sometimes what even quickens that love and that marriage is the fact that you're looking at the passports. My passport is about to change. My citizenship is about to change. So let me get into this love and just enter it. Because one thing about me is that I've seen many people like this that get married to old people and know somebody.
But would you disagree that the younger generation are not serious when it comes to, sorry, let me remove the pin. Don't you think that the younger generation are not serious when it comes to marriage? Because like even you and I, we've had relationships, but most of those relationships, we know how those relationships were rocky. So I feel like on the side of people, some people are like, yo, I know with my age, mate, they are not ready to settle down. Before our 1990-something, to decide to settle down, it would be like 30, 35, or even close to 40. That's why the younger people go for older people, because they are financially stable, they got everything they need, and then they want to settle down, which is the most important thing. They're not going to be hurrying around like that. Old man ain't going to be looking for younger boys everywhere. He's just going to settle down with that one person because of his age.
I know old men are still all around. I know old men. I know a particular man that are all around till his dead self. See, when he was called to the Lord. he was called to the Lord in the bedroom. I'm not the man, I will not mention his name, but people too know him. Nigerians that know community members well, they will know the person I'm talking about, that was even called to the Lord in the bedroom when he was holding a hand. That was when he called to the Lord. It was even supposed to be a big case, but thank God that the case did not become big, because they know that the man was holding a hand and he was called to God when they finally checked his phone. So they saw that truly this was what he was doing. And it's not as if anybody planned to kill him. And I think they even did an autopsy on his body, but that was how the matter just died. So I know people like that. Old man, very old man, should even be almost in his 60s. Or somebody I love so much, somebody I love, I respect him so much. He's so rest in peace. I will not mention his name because I mentioned that people will know him. I don't need to do that. But please, I missed him so much. But he was hovering around. One bad thing about him, he never wanted to settle down. Even the time that I was in a relationship, said that was a lie. That one even got, he got a particular, I told that one that please leave me alone. I'm no longer interested. I just want to enjoy my life, always trying to. And the funny thing is that even, it was just, I don't want to go deep into it. So I've met, it's not about your age. It's just about the mindset. And some people, it's, you know, daddy carrying me. I need the daddy. I need this. Even you are in Canada. You know what happened in Canada and UK?
Yes, we do have a lot of young people who love older men because like older people will pay your bills.
We have 90% of them. That's what they are looking for. Yeah. All these job ladies, they become basically almost jobless LGBT community members.
I remember one says he dates old people so that by the time they're like 98, 99, 2 years, 3 years into the marriage, then they inherit all the wealth. So see, I try to reason with people. I try to be very sensitive, but most people think like that. Like, okay, if I get married to this elderly man, in the next 10 years, he's not going to be alive. I'm going to have an inheritance. And that is how most of the LGBTQ members think. And we are speaking the truth in our show. We're not going to cover everything. So this is one part of people who think like this. But there are other part of people who are like, oh, I want to settle down with this person. This person needs a caregiver. I love this person. I want to be around this person. This person has the right instrument for me to work with me. This person treats me well. This person has, we have a sexual play. Together, so they settle down.
Okay, I feel like that's what I said when I saw the story. I saw it, and the wedding gown was a good wedding gown. But when I just looked at it, I said, when I see things like this, although the only reason that made me feel like it wasn't was because it wasn't like muscular. I don't know, Shad. No, some people are like that when they put on clothes, you will not know how muscular they are, you don't know their body stature. And people like Nikanon, so you can't, Nikanon puts on a suit, I'll be wondering that, where's, but when he takes off clothes, you will be saying them. So probably might be muscular inside. So I feel like maybe that's the reason why he... So to me, when I see marriages like that, when you get married to an older person, when it's a white, we say the same thing to when it's straight people. So when it comes to LGBT community members, we also tend to think the same way that, oh, you probably got married to this person because you wanted to change your citizenship. And bringing it home, where LGBTI community members, marriage and really marriage, whether I want to see more marriage in the community. Of course, I would love to see more marriage in the community. I tell people that for me, I will get married to someone probably my age or even younger because that's the kind of marriage I want to get. Because I tell people, I say, please, I don't have daddy issues. I do not have daddy issues. Only people that have daddy issues are the ones going and looking for the old papas and old mamas. It could be your preference, though. It could be. But I've seen people that they kind of use it as a thing of class. Oh, I don't deal with your age mates. I don't deal with your level. I go higher. I deal with your father's level. I deal with your grandfather's level.
I don't think that has to do with class. See, class is prestige and dignity. Dating that's somebody older than you doesn't somebody have nothing to do with dignity.
They are brokers trying to claim class. They are brokers. People
people just trying to claim class. There's nothing classy in marrying younger or older people. What's classy is how you carry yourself, the integrity you have.
And what you can do with your hands.
And what you can do with your hands.
How, you can, how impactful your life is. In the world, not trying to look for someone that will bankroll you.
Let me just put this out there. A classy person marries a poor person, he makes that person classy. But that's even if truth. You marry a poor person trying to be classy, baby, you will just be a wealthy rag.
I always say, magnets do not attract plastic. So it's just the truth. So moving on, I think we'll end with that so quickly so we don't make this episode long.
But before we go into that, though, there was something I wanted to say. I just feel like there's also this weird fantasy of white old people looking for younger black people. So it doesn't look like only the young black people that goes looking for older people. I feel like sometimes the older men feel like we are fetish because I know how many older people have reached out to me and I'm like, I'm not interested. They see us as a type of fetish in the community, which is something we need to talk about, but not on this episode. I just wanted to drop that also out there so that it doesn't look like we are one-sided.
No problem. We know that. And that's what we are calling out both sides. So the older men have their issues. That's why I talk about the older man, the older man that likes falling around. So it could be both ways and everything. So just let's just move on quickly to the other story, which is the hair. So Chimayze, if I, let's go with your Toronto ballroom. What happened in Toronto ballroom? I heard you were, Kiwi Talk was present there. You represented us. So give us our reporter, report to us. What really happened?
On the weekend, we had a very amazing Toronto Kiki ballroom, which is called the Olympic Ball, which is amazing. Now the clips from that ballroom was like touch notch. We had a lot of people who have been doing a lot of amazing things from the community. James Bailey, who I know personally, he's an artist. He has a new song which has been hitting everywhere. We can't play the song because of copyright issues, but we could show you some description on links for you to go listen to his songs on Spotify. We had another artist who also came. I've forgotten her name, but she was present there at the ballroom. The ballroom was amazing. She has a new single that dropped out on Friday. I feel like us being there at the Toronto ballroom just introduced our presence into the Canadian ballroom scene and into the Canadian LGBTQ scene too, so that they get to see us, the Nigerian community over here get to see how balls and how, what freedom can do, what coming out can do. Because so many people are like, what is the need of coming out? What is the need of fighting for or agitating for freedom in Africa? This is one of the reasons for agitating for freedom in Africa, is that we can create our own events, we can have our own community, our own gatherings peacefully. Even the neighborhood came out to watch the ballroom, people around the street. And far from that, there wasn't like any judgmental discrimination in the ballroom, because we even had a category called the sex siren, where we saw booties and yash and everything popping everywhere. So that freedom, having that freedom to do your own community event, have a community gathering, is something that is amazing. And I wish it will also extend to Africa, even starting from South Africa, which is one of the countries in Africa that is that has a good LGBT law, that is legal to be LGBTQ.
That is very good. I cannot, even me thinking of that is something good. I look forward to when this kind of things will come in Nigeria. It can still happen, but first we need to challenge the homophobic laws in Nigeria. And even without not challenging them, we'll still be on challenging them, but we can still organize something for our community members where we can come together, where we can meet, have fun. I know we are currently doing it in Nigeria. We do it a lot, and I'm just happy. And I know one day to be fully LGBTQI right, to be fully legalized in Nigeria, and then we can have things like this, and to be a glorious moment. Even something like the LGBTQI award, which happened over the weekend, the British LGBTQ award. I was impressed. I saw some people like Jide McCauley, the what's the name of that deaf comedian? I can't remember her name again. Deaf comedian. I saw people like the British Got Talent judge, Alisa, what's that her name? The black girl. There were so many good people there. Good that were nominated were Little Nas for the award, Little Nas, Lizzo. It was just a good award. I saw it, saw the goodie bags, saw everything, the performance. It was an exciting thing to watch, the British LGBTQ awards. And I felt like, when do we start having things like Nigeria that is actually big, big, big? I know that there are awards in Nigeria, LGBTQ awards, but making it big, making it glamorous, where it's just something wonderful. We look forward to that.
Even though it doesn't happen in Nigeria, I feel like the Nigerians who have migrated to places like America, Canada, and other Western countries where LGBT laws are, you know, legal, could also organize this just to have a community gathering. We must not only have LGBTQ. For example, Kiwi Talk is not only in Nigeria. It's a Nigerian, even Canadian-based media. So we can have a Nigerian gathering even here in Canada. And those who want to fly, those who want to come over, can have this freedom, have this gathering, even though it's not at our home base location, which until this law changes. Like, that is why I said we could start from South Africa. We could start from UK, we could start from places that are close to home, where we have good LGBTQ laws, and we can have this gathering, because it gives you a sense of belongingness. I can't tell you how much when I go to the ballrooms, I'm like, this is where I belong. This is where I'm free. This is where I don't get judged. This is where I can express myself. And those who vogue and who dance, you could see how they let their anxiety, depression, because sometimes you don't need all these pills. All you need is just to step out from your house, go to an event, and forget about your worries. And this is one good way to start from.
Mm. That's nice. That's true. So just finally wrapping this up, what did you do over the weekend? Was it just a... So let's just talk about what we did over the weekend in just like 1 minute. So what did you do?
For me, it was just the ballrooms and I'm editing all the footage. So guys, make sure when it drops, come and watch the full clips. The clips is long, but I'm going to try to edit it to make it short. And yeah, that's what... And I've been talking to the host and those involved in the ballrooms, and we are seeing how we can incorporate some things together. That's all I did for the weekend. And then family, which is important, every Sunday.
That's nice. So what I did over the weekend, as usual now, my rabbits were disturbing, so I had to separate them. Separated my rabbits into two different, because if I had like one, like mini cage, I still need somebody to build the cage for me. Listen, if you're a carpenter, you're watching me, and you're
a welder.
Just reach out to me. Send me a DM on Instagram, please. I beg. Let me even know my budget for a good cage. I want to know my budget so I can just be planning towards it, because my rabbits are like giving me problems. The more they get bigger, the more it's like harder to keep them in check. The more they are getting more powerful. So it's something I want to like just do, because I had to separate them over the weekend. Like I just had to separate them because they were like really, really disturbing. And as they get bigger too, I will need like a full cage where I can just get them. We need to be like one in each cage. So that's just what I've been planning over the weekend. I separated them. And also I watched a movie, an LGBTQI movie, Godless. Oh my God, that movie was touching. I think people should see that movie. That movie is very, very interesting. Godless. It showed me about...
King of Boys is what I watched on the weekend. Go on.
King of Boys, what you watch? I mean, I watched Godless for the weekend and it was just so interesting. It's just so fantastic. The ending part was just what struck me. It was an LGBTIQ movie. So people might feel offended with the movie because the movie is about two blood brothers that were sleeping together. But the ending is what just blows my mind. So
let us not go into that topic, but yeah. Let's pass. But if you are watching, just comment what you're watching beneath this video too, so we know what you guys are watching in the comment section and what you did.
I think we'll start doing a program where we'll just comment on what are you watching, a kind of content. See, me and Chimeuze will just come probably in like 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So we'll tell you, like, we'll give you guys like movies that we've been watching, maybe movies that you guys should check out. We won't play like
not hours. Just us, we need people from the community to come out. This is not just Chimeuze and Marvelous. This is community. This is an opportunity given to you guys to come. Instead of everybody doing their own one thing, this is where Rico TV, everybody come together and we build one thing together that is going to stand, because unity is power. So not just me, if you are out there watching us and you're like, I want to do something, I want to add, I want to present, opportunity day for you. Come, we'll accept you. We are not judging. Even JP Crime Fighter, come, we'll accept you. We are not judgmental.
Okay, and that's been our offering for Kiwi Talk for this episode. Breaking news, Wahala. As usual, don't forget to subscribe. If you are watching us, please stop being a hater. Subscribe. Click the subscribe button. Make us grow. Share our videos. You can also like, comment. As usual, always comment on our videos. Tell us what you would like to see. Tell us what you would like to watch. Just feel free to text us. And please, till next episode, see you guys later. Peace out.